Your lesson today is going to practice moving in and out of model space and paper space using these new commands: PS, which stands for paper space, MS, which stands for model space, and zoom extends commands, which is actually Z enter, E enter. Then you're going to create a new viewport using the MView command, MVIEW. Also, you're going to verify that you have all the correct line types. So in our previous lesson, we made a title block in model space and use the clipboard copy with base point command and pasted it into our paper space or our layout one. We renamed this tab from layout one to paper space. We also deleted any other layouts that you might have had by right clicking on that tab and deleting it. So this is where we are. I'm going to delete this viewport that is already part of our drawing to teach you how to make a new one. The command is called MView. So you type in MView, but before you do, make sure your viewport layer is current. So select the word viewport to make sure it's current up here on the screen. Then type in MView, and with your mouse, you draw a rectangle from one corner of the title block to the other. Try not to touch the border of your title block at this time. You will see that it is orange because that's the color of the layer of the viewport. And everything that you draw on this model tab will show up here. I'm going to teach you how to make the viewport disappear. Make this rectangle disappear. Make a different layer current, such as layer 0. Under the viewport tab, click what's called freeze and thaw. You're going to freeze the viewport, which turns that into a snowflake symbol. And your rectangle disappears. Now explain these commands, PS, MS, and zoom extends. Drafters have to know which space they're in. Are they in model space, paper space, and this other one? If I double click inside the viewport, this is called floating model space. This tells you that you're in floating model space. Double click outside the viewport, and you'll be back in what's called paper space. So paper space, floating model space, paper space, model space. So here we are in paper space. When you're in paper space, you could do things like update your date, update your file name, update your name, whatever you need to change in here. That's what paper space is for. It'll also be used for printing. In floating model space, we don't actually use that, but if you accidentally zoom in on here, you can see I'm controlling the drawing. You may want to double click outside of that. A common mistake we make is we zoom into this, double click on it, and zoom out to make changes to our drawing, and forget that we're in floating model space, and we can't zoom out to find our paper space. To get out of there, you have to use this command called PS. So I type in PS enter, and I can zoom out now, and there's my title block. And of course, my drawing is really small. To get back into the viewport, the command is MS. MS enter. To bring my drawing back to the right size, I type in Z enter, E enter. And then I type in PS to get back out. You might hear me say, can you do a MS enter, Z enter, E enter, PS enter? That means doing a series of commands, because perhaps, for example, your drawing might be off to the side, so I need you to fix everything. You just quickly type in MS enter, Z enter, E enter, PS enter, and you're back out of the title block. Another common mistake we have is we accidentally click on the viewport. Let me turn it back on with our mouse and double click it, and it pops into this window, which looks like you're in model space, but as you can see down here, we're not. The red border tells you, warning, you're in model space, floating model space. You need to get back out of there. The command is PS, enter, and now I'm back out. All right, now that you understand how to use viewports, we are now going to actually attach it to our border like you see here, so that when it's frozen, not only is it the same size as the border, but you also can't see it anymore. Now, how to get rid of the grid. To get rid of the grid, double click inside the viewport or type in MS, enter, and down here, T Take off grid display. And your grid is now off. Type in PS Enter or double click outside. And when you save our work, we always want to save when we're in Paperspace, so we should be able to see our title block. We should be able to see our logo that indicates Paperspace. Finally, never draw in Paperspace. Let me give you an example. I'm going to make the hidden line layer current, draw a circle, which you can see right there, and it appears if I've drawn inside the drawing, but if I click on Model tab, it's not there. It's because I've actually drawn on the paper space here. Try avoid doing that. If you see missing dimensions, don't dimension either up here, because as you can see, I can still grab things even though I'm in paper space and measure that. I can still grab items and measure it while I'm in paper space. And you're going to see that there's discrepancies. Here's the real version of size of 11 inches. This is what I get when I measure in paper space. As you can see, there's nothing measured at all. What this means is I'm not measuring my actual lines, I'm measuring the visual image of that line. So let me erase those also. Notice I can't erase anything else with that's inside because it's in model space. Remember not to dimension or draw while you're in paper space. Only draw while you're here, and we're going to print while we're here, and that'll be the next lesson.